haven't done a motorcycle vlog for some time, so I had a problem actually with the audio on this camera. I had to put a new microphone. The old microphone broke, so now I've got a new microphone in there. Hopefully it'll work, we'll soon find out. We meet up with Colin, he's riding with the Vintage group today, and I'm riding my Royal Enfield Himalayan 411, the old one that no one really wants to look at anymore. So yeah, I like it. It's still my favourite little bike, to be honest with you. Anyway, let's get my helmet on, let's get moving. Says he, you can hear my audio. So I'm making my way now to go and see Colin. He's just round the corner actually. He keeps his motorcycle over here, and I got to meet him at his garage. And oop, speed humps. I'm not sure where he's going, so it's a bit of a mystery tour. But I'm sure it'd be a good day out. I know it's a Vintage Club motorcycle meetup, so there should be some old bikes there, but I think a lot of them are also going to be on modern bikes as well. Anyway, nice day for it. Nice day for it. Sunshine, temperature's not going to be too hot, about 15 or 16 degrees C. No rain. That's it. See every day we got an old traction engine. The old steam fairs are there. They are, look, beautiful to see. Goodness me. But yeah, very interesting. Look at that, look. Making its way along Queen's Drive in Swindon. Proper vintage, that. I'm making our way to meet the others, but we're coming into an area known as Wiltshire. There, you can't quite see it, but there's they're doing the old canal. Redoing the canal back there. Look at these old cars, look. And this is a new housing estate area. This was Greenbelt land once upon a time, and they did say they would never build upon it, but here we are, look. This is the Greenbelt land as it is now. Welcome to Wiltshire. One thing they have done, which is quite nice, I think, they put this beautiful sculpture in the middle of the roundabout. So that's quite unusual. Quite what that is supposed to be or mean, I don't know, but I think it's quite nice. Well, we're now coming into Royal Wootton Bassett, and we meet the other vintage motorcycle and non-vintage motorcycles just around the corner, I think. So hopefully there will be some vintage bikes on this ride, and probably one or two vintage riders as well. Well, I'm not far short of that category, being in my 60s. Here we are, just round here they should be. So far there's one, from what I can see. So here is that vintage bike with its vintage rider.
Pardon?
The lovely AJS.
Yep.
Yeah, they're saying a vintage bike with a vintage rider.
Yeah.
Beautiful. How old is this one then?
1960.
It's older than me. I was born in 62.
A lot of people say that.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I was born in 63, so older than me as well. Look at that.
Yeah.
I was born in 1940.
1940, was it?
1940, baby.
Yeah. There you go, look. Look at that, isn't that beautiful? Thank God they don't make them like that anymore.
Yeah. What's that you got on there?
That's a camera, I'm filming you.
He's interviewing you.
You're being filmed.
Oh,
you'll be famous. We got another bystander stop by. Look, it's reminding him of his youth when he was a young person. Look, the rider of this machine is 82 years of age.
First end to end, I've done it on the flat tank Royal Enfield. Rhett's got a Colt.
Oh, has he?
Yeah,
I'm filming this on the 360 camera. So, hopefully, I'll be able to bring you some highlights. Well, I had to overlay music on this part of the video because the 360 camera just doesn't record the ambient noise very well. When you're moving along or if there's any wind, it just completely overwhelms the microphone. So if I put this little music clip in for you, it's called Dude, Where's My Horse? And it's available to download for free from the YouTube library. Brian led us through all the back roads of this part of Wiltshire. We rode mostly in an area between Wootton Bassett and Chippenham, and finally arrived at Sutton Benger. So I've got the clips that I've recorded with the 360 camera, and they're overlaid with the music, and then we stopped for a break, and then afterwards I had some more clips that I filmed with the GoPro, and I put my own audio over that, so you'll be able to hear me talking toward the end of this video. Right, back to the music. to fill up the SD card on my 360 camera, just in time actually. We're stopping at this place, I believe, for some refreshments. Into the market town of Tetbury. Quite a nice old place this. Lots of stone built buildings, houses and shops, a little market square. I know King Charles, when he was a prince, he lived not far away from Tetbury. Proudly flying the Union flag. Yeah, lots of Union flags being flown here, which is good to see. I think you can agree with me, it's quite a nice high street, Tetbury. A lot of character. Leaning, the buildings seem to lean a little bit, they're all a little bit higgledy-piggledy. This group ride is being led by the old boy. He's 82 on his old AJS, so a nice steady pace. I don't think we've gone over 35 mile an hour, but you don't have to go fast to enjoy yourself. You don't need big motorbikes, you don't need lots of power, and especially with the roads these days, most of these roads are sort of 40 and 50 mile an hour anyway. I think the time of the big powerful motorcycles is coming to an end on the public roads anyway. Looks like we're turning left here. Now the old Enfield 411 that I'm riding is just over 24 brake horsepower. And for 95% of my motorcycling, it's all I need. I come across places on this ride that I've never been to before. So that's a new one, that tree over there. I haven't seen that before. Yeah, some always nice to sort of find new roads that you haven't been along. cooler, and yeah, there's a sort of feeling of that it might rain. I hope not, but clouds are a bit, the sky's a bit grey as well, but that's the variable nature of motorcycling in the United Kingdom, or should I say England. The landscape is certainly changing, and it's becoming a bit more Cotswoldy, I'd say. Cotswold stone walls, I'm beginning to notice, and they're more more open vista. Well, vistas. Will he get it started? Oh, there we are, he's fired up.
There is. I do wonder, Rhett, because he wasn't feeling very well this morning, that's why he's not coming. But I did
wonder, we've enjoyed our ride.
The
Colin's having a bit of banter with Brian at the moment. Brian is the chap which organised this ride. So Brian and Colin wanted to say a few words. But anyway, from me, I'll say thanks for watching. And I'll catch you on the next one.
Well, Brian, I just want to thank you for a really interesting day out and travelling on roads that even I haven't been on before. Yeah. And the interesting thing for me is you use the same sat-nav system as I use here.
Yeah.
We don't need technology.
No.
We just need to know where we're going.
That's right, yeah.
Brilliant.
Thanks very much, Brian.
That's all right, thank you.
We enjoyed
that.
Thank you
for your support.
Yeah.
Is there another one in September? Yeah.